Australia is hands down the best country in the world. But why does my opinion matter? I'm a first generation migrant. 23 years ago, my parents embarked on a journey across oceans, leaving behind everything familiar for a promise of a better life, a better future for their kids. Now, moving 14 hours away from family and friends with the hope of seeing their kids build a future for themselves might get everyone confused, but was it worth it? And why would someone move to Australia today? Well, here are three reasons why I love this great country. Number one is it's a democratic and free society. Now, this is a land where democracy isn't just a word. It's our way of life.
Gentlemen, this is Democracy Manifest.
Influenced by Judeo-Christian values, our freedoms in speech, faith, press, and education aren't just given, they were fought for. They were defended by millions to protect our future and our very identity. Number two is this is a land of opportunity. The land of opportunity with terrific quality of life, with affordable healthcare, education, and support systems. Now, if you disagree, you'd be struggling to find economies and populations of similar sizes with the luxuries that we have here. Now, a great example is the two largest hubs of Australia, Melbourne and Sydney, are 3 and 4 on the Global Livability Index. So it just goes to show. Now, number three and the final reason I love this great country, you'd think it'd be the beaches, the landscape, but actually it's not. It's the people. It's the people, the culture, the laid-back culture that doesn't take itself too seriously. The type of culture where what you do or who you are doesn't matter when you're across the table from someone at the pub with a beer in your hand. It's a type of culture where you hate the government and will snob off the Prime Minister.
Nah, you're an idiot, mate. You really are.
But be oddly respectful and compliant to what the government wants and needs. It's a multicultural society that appreciates banter, laughing at ourselves and each other. My best memories of growing up at school was actually being surrounded by mates from different cultures, where we'd have constant banter about each other's cultures and sometimes our own culture. It just helped us to forge close friendships and defend each other when it came down to it. Now, the complexity of this country, however, lies with the history of this great nation. It's a nation with an indigenous population, which was composed of over 250 language groups with their own social, cultural, and spiritual traditions. And it was an indigenous population which did get ravaged through disease, violence, conflict. And it is a terrible part of history, but it was sadly a part of the realities of the world at that time and at that stage in the era of conquest and colonization. Now, 1600s and 1700s, as an example, saw the superpowers of the world in England, Spain, Portugal, France, Netherlands, and Russia conquer countries for land, claim and colonize to expand their dynasties. A couple of centuries before, you saw the ruthless conquests of the Ottoman empires and the Mughal empire. And a century before that was the Mongols. So the realities of history in that era was horrible and wrong. But we have since moved into the age of coexistence and peace largely throughout the world. Now, if we continue to focus on what divides us through history, we can never work on what unites us in the present and in the future. Now, I love this country, but there are many in the country that do not. There are many that want to see us divided rather than talk about true unity and reconciliation. And the more that I've lived in this beautiful country, however, I've realized that although we all come from different parts of the earth, we are one under this banner and this flag. As the I Am Australian song goes, and from all the lands on earth we come, we share a dream and we sing with one voice. One voice. We are one, although we are many. Which is why every Australia Day, I reflect on the history of this great country. Its highs, its lows. I reflect on the stories of those that defended and continue to defend this country. I reflect on the stories of those that built this great nation. The Indigenous, the First Fleet onwards, the soldiers, the builders, the migrants. And above all, I reflect on the people of this great nation. And I do all of this with so much pride. With pride of how far we've come. And how far we will continue to go as we hold true to who we are as a nation. Remember, I am, you are, we are Australian. Happy Australia Day.
We are one, but we are many, and from all the lands on earth we come, we'll share a dream. Share a dream.